So without further ado, I would like to play a welcome message from our school council co-chair, Andrew Zalvin.
My name is Andrew Zalvin. I'm the father of a grade 11 student, and on behalf of the Northview Heights Secondary School School Council, I'd like to welcome you to tonight's orientation. Parents and guardians, I encourage you to participate in school council events. They're a great opportunity to learn about what's happening at the school, opportunities for your student, strategies for supporting your student during their high school years, and a chance to connect with other members of this community, the principal, vice principal, guidance counselors, members of the teaching faculty, and in particular, other parents and guardians. It's easy when your student enters high school to feel cut off from this part of their life. School council is another link to the school. And in these times, it's important to feel that you're a part of a supportive community, to recognize that you're not alone and that we are in this together. I look forward to meeting you next fall.
And now I'd like to welcome Farouk Sultanov, the president of Student Council.
And on behalf of the Northview Heights Secondary School,
Hello, everyone. For some reason, my camera glitched out, so I can't turn it on. But welcome, everyone. My name is Farouk Sultanov, and as was stated previously, I am the president of Northview Heights Secondary School. Now, Northview runs a truly incredible organization called the Student Council, which essentially promotes student leadership and brings together a group of truly remarkable people, as you can see in front of you, that come up with incredible ideas on how to improve the school for the better, and also creating incredible events that support students and make it as inclusive as possible. So if we can go to the next slide now. So as you can see in front of you, we have come up with some incredible events, right? Such as the Terry Fox Run that has raised over $400 during our virtual experience. And this has been a truly tremendous achievement, especially for Northview. And in addition to that, we've done some incredible events and such as like the Halloween event or the mental health and wellness event that thoroughly supported students in a very difficult time. So I hope that your children will be joining us next year to take part in this incredible organization that we have, which is the Student Council. Now to pass it on to our incredible Vice Principal, Ms. Johnson, to talk further about Northview Heights. Thank you.
Ms. Johnson, you're muted.
Thank you, Farouk. Welcome again, everyone. Usually on this amazing night, we would have not only a presentation where you get to hear about all the amazing programs, but you would actually get to see Northview Heights in action. You would get a tour of our various departments, interact with our various leaders, student leaders, teachers, curriculum leaders. But of course, given the pandemic, that part has, you know, have to go by the wayside. But our heads have prepared a highlight of their various departments for you. So over the next almost 15 or so minutes, please give your attention to the screen as you watch highlights of our various programs. Thank you, Ms. Tanrakul, if you could play the video.
Thank you. dancing guard for the Modernist Department at Northview Heights. French is the official language of 29 countries. There are around 220 million French speakers worldwide, and learning French is great for travel and possibly getting an edge for your future career. French is a compulsory course in grade 9. Grade 9 students can choose from three different courses: FSF 1D, Academic, FSF 1P Applied. Both of these courses require a minimum of 600 hours of French. There's FSF 1O, which is for ESL students and students who have not taken the 600 hours of French. This chart shows our core French program outlined in blue. As you can see, we have the academic core French courses from grades 9 to 12. This shows all of our French and Spanish courses. If you complete the grades 9 to 12 French courses, you will get a certificate of achievement. For those interested in learning Spanish, we also have grade 10 and 11 Spanish courses. York University's Glendon campus visits us annually to inform our grades 11 and 12 French students about the multitude of opportunities if you continue pursuing French in university. We asked students why they wanted to continue studying French, and they said to get their certificate of core French, to help them with jobs, and to communicate with other people when they travel. All courses are taught by enthusiastic teachers who provide students with an exciting and challenging learning environment where they can practice all aspects, speaking, listening, reading, and writing of the languages. Merci, gracias, and thank you from the Northview Moderns Department.
This feeling inside my bones, it goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home, we're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet, feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. So don't stop. And under the lights, when everything goes, nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. So just to let you know. Rushing on. I don't need no reason, don't need control. I fly so high, no ceiling when I'm in my zone. Cause I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet, I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. Come on, like the way we rock it, so don't stop, stop, stop. Under the lights, when everything goes, nowhere to hide when I'm getting too close. When we move, where you already know. So just imagine. So just dance, dance, dance.
ESL students mostly from? Well, they're from the Philippines, Iran, Vietnam, various countries in South America, different parts of Eastern Europe, Russia, different parts of Asia. But no matter where you're from, everyone is welcome at North Jew Heights. Welcome, grade 8 students, parents, guardians, to the ESL department presentation. Academic language acquisition takes more time than social language acquisition. It takes 1 to 2 years to develop social English skills and 5 or more years to develop academic English skills. Our ESL program comprises of 5 levels, from ESLA to ESLE. You can see on the chart that there are different pathways to English, for example, from ESLD to grade 9 English, or ESLE to grade 11 English. Successful completion of ESLE leads to grade 10 English and grade 11 English. Ideally, a student should achieve a 75% or higher in ESLE to be best prepared for English 3U. We have many leadership and support services at Northview. For example, the Film Can Club, ESL Club. We have the CUBA Buy-In After School Program, the Guidance Ambassador Program, the Laws Program, and the Welcoming Communities TESB Newcomer Youth Program. We also have the speech competition. Fundraising events. Singing in dance clubs. Amazing field trips. And even a field trip to see the Raptors 905. Thank you very much, everyone. Have a great night.
and guardians. The Northview guidance team wants to welcome all of you. At Northview, we have 4 full-time guidance counselors to assist in all aspects of students' educational needs, academic, career, and personal, as they are working towards their Ontario Secondary School diploma. My name is Ms. Tanri Kulu, and I am the Assistant Curriculum Leader for Guidance.
Hi, I'm Ms. Dobbin. I'm a guidance counselor at Northview.
Hi, I'm Ms. Allison, and I'm a guidance counselor and the ACL, or Assistant Curriculum Leader of Student Success.
Hi, and I'm Ms. PT. I'm also one of the guidance counselors here at Northview Heights. We all work together as a team to help students be as successful as they can be. We look forward to meeting our new students and working with them and their families. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Actually, there's more teachers, obviously, right? But we're here to talk to you about Northview Science. So when you come to Northview, the first thing is grade 9 science. And in grade 9 science, what you have is a bunch of teachers who work together very closely. And we all do the same thing. And we all help each other out. And we also help each other's students out. So we support all of our students to make sure that they succeed. And then in grade 10, we work on things like building up study habits and making sure that if they choose to go to senior sciences, like grade 11 and grade 12, they have the ability to do so. So in grade 9, we're trying to transition them into high school, and then grade 10, if they're interested in science, we're trying to transition them into the senior level sciences. So we hope that you choose us. We try to offer a supportive community, and we try to do our best job. Our science teachers are all knowledgeable and have plenty of experience. So thank you for working.
Yes, and I hope you think we're fun, right? So for example, change is coming. So we're also very, we love our subject maybe too much, right? But anyway, thank you. We hope you choose us. Yeah.
All right, thank you everyone. So that's a quick overview of our various departments. I saw some of our grade eights were quite excited, and that's good to see. Now, I know, Seville, Ms. Tanakulu, if you could, next slide, yeah. One of the most important things I'm sure you're wondering is which high school to go to know what is your home school, that is the high school or secondary school, it means the same thing, that serves your residential area. You need to go onto the TDSB website, www.tdsb.on.ca. And as soon as you land on that page, at the very top of the website, you will see, and we have it circled, find your school. Once you click on find your school, you have three options to find which high school or secondary school is your home school, the one that services your residential area. You can search by address. In this mode, you, please back up, thank you. In this mode, you simply type in the name of your street. So if you live on Bathurst, you simply type Bathurst or Finch, and it will take you to a list of screen for you to select to see which high school serves your specific address. If you think Northview is your home school, you can also search by school name. So you would type in Northview Heights. On that screen, you would see the area that Northview Heights services and determine whether your address is in that particular area that's shown on a map. The third way is by programs. If you know a specific program you would like to go to, like our HMSD or a cyber arts program, when you click on programs, it gives you the high schools where these different programs can be found. Next slide, please. If Northview Heights is not your home school, you must apply through the board's optional attendance process. If you're seeking acceptance to a specialized program at Northview Heights, you also must use this optional attendance, complete this optional attendance form. Last week, Thursday night, we had an information night for our specialized programs, APCA, for athletes, cyber arts on HMSD. If you're applying to these programs, even if Northview is your home school, you must still fill out an optional attendance form. If you are not in our area, so Northview Heights is not your home school and you're planning on applying to one of our specialized programs, I also recommend that you apply for a regular program all through optional attendance. Now, our school is what's known as a limited school. This means we can only take a certain number of students through optional attendance. If we get more applicants than there are available spots, then we have to go through what's called a lottery. Okay, thank you. Next slide. Some important deadlines around optional attendance. The board's optional attendance form, which once again you must use if Northview is not your home school, and as well if you're applying to our specialized programs, that form is due on Friday, January 29th, 2021. If you get in, your parents or your guardians will be informed by February 12th, 2021. You must accept or declare whether you are coming to Northview or accepting our offer by February 26th, 2021. Next slide. For optional attendance or even our specialty programs, the board allows you to apply for two specialized programs as well as two regular programs under optional attendance. So for example, in our school, you can apply for APCA and HMST or HMST and cyber arts, but maximum of two specialized programs and two of our regular programs, right? If Northview is your home school, you do not have to apply to our regular programs. It's automatic you would go to our regular programs. If, however, you're applying to our specialized programs like APCA, like HMSD or Cyber Arts, then you must apply through using our optional attendance form, as well as the specific application forms for each of these programs, which we'll review again at the end of the program. Remember I said last week we had a session for these three programs, but we'll provide some overview of the deadlines for their applications near the end of tonight. That information is also already posted on our website. Students will be filling out their course selections in February. This is after you would have selected a school and you've applied to and have gotten into a program. Then you will commence the work of course selection in February with your guidance counselors. Next slide. Okay, so I will now turn it over to Ms. Tanrikulu, who is the Assistant Curriculum Leader of Guidance, who will continue with our presentation. Ms. Tanrikulu.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Northview Guidance Department. Your school guidance counselor will oversee your high school journey and is your first contact for any questions you may have about your school or other personal issues. Sorry. Choices for 9 is an interactive guide for parents and students and guardians. This guide will give you the tools you need to help in the decision-making process when making your future plans for your future. By clicking on the links, you will find an abundance of information related to the grade 8 to 9 transition process. TDSB offers a variety of different programs to enhance student learning, such as specialized programs, specialist high skills majors, co-op, technical education programs, dual credit programs, and Ontario Youth Apprenticeship programs. Vice Principal Melissa White will be speaking further about the 3 SHISM programs that we have in our school later on in this presentation. You may be asking yourselves, what are the requirements for your Ontario Secondary School Diploma? The first requirement is earning 30 credits. 18 of those credits are compulsory and 12 are elective. Another requirement is 40 hours of community involvement, which is volunteering. Yesterday, we had our virtual volunteer fair. So Northview Guidance Department offers 2 annual volunteer fairs that where we invite representatives from our community to come into our school and help our students find volunteer placements in our community. The third requirement is our grade 10 literacy test. Students are expected to take 8 courses each year. In grade 12, students are allowed to have spares. To pass a course, a student must achieve 50% or higher. In high school, there is no promotion. Once a course is passed, a credit is earned. This year, due to COVID-19, we are on a quadmester schedule, meaning that the 8 courses that students are required to take are broken down for students, and they take their courses 2 courses 4 times in the year. There is a synchronous and asynchronous learning component to this. However, Northview is typically a semestered school where students would take 4 courses from September to January. They will write their exams. And from February to June, they will take their other 4 courses and write their exams in June. Here is an example of a grade 9 timetable. As part of the board's multi-year strategic plan, the board is committed to the majority of high school students studying at the academic level. Research shows that when students choose academic programs, they experience more positive outcomes. The majority of courses offered in grades 9 and 10 are 1 of 2 types. academic or open. At Northview, all core courses, math, English, science, and geography are offered at the academic level with some exceptions. For students who may benefit from additional support in areas of numeracy and literacy, Northview offers credit-granting bridging courses in math and English. These courses are offered in the first semester, where students will prepare for their academic math and English courses in the second semester. Grade 8 teachers will help your child in the course selection process in February and will assist you in any questions you may have with respect to course selections. Open courses generally fall into the elective category. They are not destination-based and have a common set of expectations for all students, and they complement all pathways. They are not destination-based, therefore there are no prerequisites that are required for in grade 11 for these courses. There are many different pathways in which students can take after high school: apprenticeship, university, workplace, college, and community living. And the Toronto District School Board honors and respects all pathways. Creating Pathways for Success is a provincial policy document that guides educational and career life planning from kindergarten through to grade 12. The framework of the Education and Career Life Planning Program is a four-step inquiry process based on four questions linked to four areas of learning. Who am I? What are my opportunities? Who do I want to become? And what is my plan for achieving my goals? In order to make the best possible decisions during this grade 8 to 9 transition, it is beneficial to take this inquiry approach. My Blueprint is an online education, career, and life planning guide available to all TDSB students from grade 7 to grade 12 and their families. It is designed to present and future planning. This is an excellent resource because it allows students to, 1, start planning and exploring now for future careers and post-secondary opportunities. 2, plan and select courses for high school. And 3, research occupations, jobs, and budgeting. This program allows students the unique opportunity to learn more about themselves by using a variety of self-assessment tools to better understand who they are as individuals. Each student is expected to develop an individual pathways plan each year throughout the course of their high school career. This will help them reflect, be mindful of how they are changing, and make well-informed decisions throughout their high school career. Parents and guardians can also set up their own My Blueprint account, or they can link their account to their child's account. Tutorials and videos are available on the My Blueprint website on www.myblueprint.ca/TDSB. This forward slash TDSB is very important and must be included when creating an account. What can families do to help students make good choices? First, you can access and investigate My Blueprint Career Planning Tool. You can also attend secondary information evenings and open houses. Encourage continued participation in extracurricular activities. Choose courses of interest and discuss future plans. Stay involved and connected with the school and meet the deadlines. Now I will pass it to Miss Karuna. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss Tamrikulu. All right, so some generic school information. We actually have a TDSB Connect school app, which is accessible to provide range of communication tools and productivity tools for all our students. And this includes some amazing features. So students can access daily announcements, school calendar, their own timetables. They have access to that, school handbook, and many other resources. So this is how the app looks like on their phone. If we can move on to the next slide, just to share the view of the app. Thank you. So it has the My Day feature that gives them their current schedule. It has a timetable feature. It provides pertinent school information, access to regular announcements, the calendar feature that tells them what day it is, and many other school resources. Next. All right, at Northview, we have an exceptional English language learners, the ESL department that prepares students for success in English and other courses. The ESL credits actually count for compulsory English credit to a maximum of 3 credits. ESL students will be assessed by the TDSB Reception Center. Usually the process happens in spring, and then they get placed in a level of the ESL class, and they can definitely move to academic courses when appropriate. So ESL department is very vibrant at Northview, and we embrace different cultures and provide a variety of subjects and clubs related to that as well. Next. I know in the chat, there were many questions around special education supports. So this section of our presentation is geared to what does special education look like at Northview. We have an amazing team of GLE teachers. GLE stands for Learning Strategies Course. So students with an IEP have access to this course, which happens one each year. So they can get up to 4 GLE courses throughout their high school journey from grades 9 to 12. At Northview, we have access to assistive technology. Students are using a variety of assistive technology tools based on their IEP. We also work with teachers across different subjects and departments to support the learning needs of all students. We ensure that the IEP of student is followed and they're receiving the instructional environmental assessment accommodations that are identified in their IEPs. We also work collaboratively with parents, students, and teachers in the ongoing development of an IEP document, making it live. We also work in conjunction with our guidance and guidance team to support our students through transition in school and to a variety of post-secondary pathways. Further to that, we distribute and maintain all the SIA claim technology. So students with exceptionality have access to devices that as a department, we do claims for them and ensure that they gain access to the assistive technology through either a group claim or an individual computer just to access curriculum. Furthermore, our vibrant special education staff includes a team of educational assistants, special needs assistants, and child and youth worker who support students in an ongoing fashion through various skills such as self-regulation, social skills development, enhanced student well-being and wellness. They can either be, the CYWs could be either be assigned individually or to a group class or a program. They communicate information related to classroom strategies geared towards success for all our special education learners. Next slide. Here are some pictures from our amazing educational support workers and their work with our students. Since we went remote, they're actually also available via online platforms to engage in learning with the students. Here's our Student Success and Wellness Center. It's a safe place for students to receive academic, emotional, and social supports. Next. I know there were questions around the autism program. Northview offers two credit potential intensive support programs, the autism ISP and the mild intellectual disability, the MID ISP. They are partially integrated programs. What that means is that students will be in small self-contained courses within the ISP and integrated courses with support. So usually the partial integrated means that 50% of their time, they would be in a smaller core courses, and then they get some optional courses where they're integrated with the mainstream students. The focus in each ISP is skill building with direct instruction. Here is our Northview's brand new sensory space. It's a sensory room geared towards our students with exceptionality, especially in the autism program. We're really proud that it's being used as a proactive measure for students to gain a sense of calm and release any kind of stresses they have. And here's our curriculum leader for special education, Ms. Hammond, and here's her contact information. And over to Mr. Oppenheimer. I know Ms. Tenrikulu mentioned that Ms. White is talking to this section, but actually we're gonna hear from one of our SHSM teachers, Mr. Oppenheimer. Thank you.
Hi folks, can you hear me?
Yes, we can, Mr. Oppenheimer.
Okay, I mean, I can start my video if you would like. So what is the SHSM program? As you can see from this slide, it's a specialized program which is approved by the Ministry of Education that allows students to focus their learning on a specific sector while meeting the requirements of the Ontario Secondary School Diploma. This is a program which starts in grade 11. So I know many of you are just entering into high school grade 9, but it's good to know about it. So these programs enable students to gain sector-specific skills and knowledge in engaging career-related learning environments. And they prepare the students in a focused way for graduation and post-secondary education training or employment. Next slide. So there's several components. It's when the student enters into the SHSM program, they earn certifications. They take specific course cooperative education courses to get real hands-on experience. And there's a bundle of grade 11 and 12 courses, which they're required to take, which are specific to each of the three different SHSM programs. There's many different reach ahead opportunities. And these are those opportunities where students can connect with maybe colleges or universities or guest speakers to sort of learn what the road ahead looks like. And then we also have sector-specific partnered experiences in math, coding, or ICE, which is commonly known as innovation, creativity, and entrepreneurship. So we have three different SHSM programs at Northview: arts and culture, hospitality and tourism, and information and communication technology, which is the one I'm involved with. This is one of the programs which the SHSM program, which was actually just launched this year, and it's the arts and it's called the Arts and Culture SHSM, and the person that you see on the left, the avatar, is Mr. Simpson. But if you want to sign up for this, you consider yourself creative, and you want to learn more about careers that need your skill set, this is one you should probably look at. And we do have a cyber arts program at our school, but this Arts and Culture SHSM program opens up the sort of creative courses to all types of students who want to explore that side of their skill set. Next slide. The Hospitality and Tourism program, that's an avatar of Miss Arima, who heads that program. If you love cooking and baking, then this is for you. You can earn your Red Seal, which is something with it, it's a it's it's kind of like a certification that's awarded when you get to the end of your SHSM program. And again, it's an amazing program which really specializes, I mean, grade 11 and 12, if you have a passion in baking or cooking or in the culinary sector. And then there's the ICT SHSM. And this one, again, you can also earn a red seal. But this is a little bit more for students who like to program, design apps, a really kind of hands-on, very computer-centric. And we have a number of students, about 40 to 50 students in the grade 11 and 12, in grades 11 and 12 who are involved in our ICT SHSM this year. Next slide. So a big part of being involved in a SHSM is thinking, connecting, and experiencing your learning. And these are just a couple photos just to demonstrate, or I guess illustrate, how we take what the students learn in the classroom, whether it's baking, they take that knowledge and they apply, for example, into a co-op, which is a cooperative education, maybe a work placement for a semester. And then they take that experience and then it gets applied to maybe George Brown College and other, other areas. Again, these are other photos of various experiences that students can receive in the SHSM program. And you can see again, lots of ways to experience their learning, whether it's competitions or whether it's guest speakers, field trips, and special programs that special experts, which we invite into the classroom to teach in these specialized areas. So these are the benefits. If the students have a passion for a particular sector, then we can customize their education to suit their interests and talents. We develop the specialized knowledge and skills that are valued by the sector and post-secondary education institutions. They earn credits that are recognized by post-secondary institutions. It's very sector specific, very focused on career certification and training. They gain confidence in their knowledge in their sector, and they identify and explore those career goals. And we work with the students to really find out where they want to go and what their pathways and where their pathways may lead them. Again, it's very flexible. We students can maintain, they can shift between these different pathways. Next slide. So if you have any questions about SHSM, grade 11 and 12 is when this all comes about. So looking forward to meeting some of your students when they arrive at Northview.
Hi everyone. Next up, we're going to talk a little bit about why you should choose Northview Heights Secondary School. There's a lot that Northview has to offer. To start off with, there are a lot of programs at Northview Heights. So you've already heard about a few of them this evening. Beyond our specialty programs, which were presented last week, and there is a recording on our school website, we also have other programs available to all students in some of the upper grades. Mr. Oppenheimer just spoke about the SHSM program in grade 11 and 12. There's also co-op, and in particular, our Steps to Construction co-op program. So these give students the opportunity to take part in some real hands-on learning. And we have a lot of other great courses, such as photography, phys ed, a lot of tech courses, and a lot of unique experiences and courses you can get involved in at Northview. Next slide, please. Beyond just programs and academics, we also have a lot more to offer. The best experience a student can have is not just in the classroom, but as an entire school community, which includes beyond the classroom as well. Northview has a lot of different facilities attached to it. And within those facilities, we have sports and co-curricular athletic programs. So you've heard earlier, we have Esther Shiner Stadium, which is just behind our school. We have a full auditorium, we have a pool, and beyond that, we have different things that happen during the year, such as our sports recognition assemblies, such as our athletic banquet at the end of the year, and we have a whole lot of extracurricular things beyond as well. Next slide, please. Two of our most popular sports are basketball and volleyball. Our boys basketball team, they had a huge victory last year, so there have been a lot of great sports experiences. Next slide, please. You can see in one of these photos our Northview mascot, who appears in some of our larger events. It's always a mystery who's inside the mascot. Next slide. Our tennis team has also achieved medal status in the last year. Blue and Gold Day is something that we celebrate regularly at Northview each year. Blue and gold are our school colors, and so at a lot of our sporting events, you will see these colors displayed prominently. We also have Spirit Days throughout the year. One example is Twin Day, but sometimes we have such things as Pajama Day. We've had Formal Wear Day, so different things to get students involved, to get students just having some fun beyond the classroom as well. Our athletic banquet is an event that should not be missed at the end of every year. Even COVID-19 could not stop us last year. We had our virtual athletic banquet in June. Beyond athletics, because not everybody has an interest in sports, we also have a lot of different clubs and councils to offer in Northview. Last year, in the 2019-2020 school year, we saw over 30 clubs and councils running at Northview. Some of the most prominent ones: Student Council, Phoenix Athletic Council, Business Club, our GSA Club, Northview Harmonics, and our Northview Environmental Action Team. Now, I'm not going to read the name of every single club to you. However, I do want to recognize that this wide variety of clubs comes from student choice. So it's not just teachers who are choosing the clubs to run, but we encourage students to put forward proposals, to get staff advisors on their side, and to make things happen. So if you come to Northview and there's something that you have in mind that you'd like to see happen extracurricularly, then all you need to do is find a staff advisor, or you can find me. My name is Ms. Jurek, and I am our ACL for student leadership, and we can work to help you get something up and running. Next slide, please. Our PhilCan Club is a club that is supporting our Filipino-Canadian students at the school. Last year, it saw so many neat events happening. They were part of many of our assemblies. We had a lot of different speakers come in and a lot of different sports activities and workshops for them. So that was a club that, again, I think it's new in the last 3 years we've seen it, but it's been growing larger every year. We had a wellness walking group last year. On Wednesdays, a group of students and teachers would get together just to go for a walk and to support some good mental health initiatives. So finding ways to de-stress, finding ways to help feel positive. And this was just one example. Last year as well, we had a group of students coordinate efforts through our President's Council to put together a great school-wide initiative for a mental health week, which we called Northview Cares. This was completely student led, and we had leaders of different clubs throughout the school come together to put something school wide, meaning offering everyone in the school the opportunity to participate. And we had events ranging from workshops to games to competitions to presentations. And we're hoping to see more great things, not just this year, but next year as well. So I really want to encourage all students and parents. I also hope that you encourage your children, not just to come to Northview to do your academics, but also to get involved. High school is about academics, but it's also about discovering more about yourself, making social connections, and learning about the world around you. So we hope that you will come and enjoy a whole new world of friendship and experiences with us. Next slide, please. These are just some examples of some of the events that have happened through the year. We had our arts night, we had a Halloween bake sale. We often have a lot of bake sales throughout the year for different events. And at the beginning of the year, and really before the year even starts, we have a few special programs just for grade nines. So first of all, there's the Jump Start program, which happens in July in summer school, and it's open to all grade eights who are coming to Northview for their grade nine program. And it's a chance to get acclimated to the school. In this program, you get to practice some skills, but you also get to meet new students and make new friends. You get to learn about the school and find your way around the large building, and you also earn a credit in doing so. So this program happens in July. It's basically a month-long program. It typically happens in the school. Last year it happened online as a result of COVID-19 protocol, but we are hoping to see it run again next summer. Beyond that, we also offer a head start to high school. So basically a grade 9 orientation where we invite our grade 9s to come in, usually the week before school starts, to get their timetable in advance, to get a chance to be in the building and find their way around, and to find their classrooms, because Northview is a large building. So it's nice to have just the grade nines in for a day so that they can experience the hallways before everyone else arrives. Next slide, please. So last but not least, I want to encourage people to stay in touch. There's lots of different ways that you can keep in contact with the school. We do have our Twitter account. You can see our hashtags on the screen. Our website has a lot of great information. We encourage you to go there regularly, www.northviewheights.ca. A lot of people have been asking information about the specialty programs, and you can find the recording from last week on the website. Last but not least, there is the TDSB Connects app, and we're encouraging students to make sure that they do have that app so that we can communicate information from the school. And we can keep everyone in the loop, because again, with such a large school community, we really have to work at making sure that we are communicating with everybody. So we ask you to help by finding one of these communication methods or more and staying in the loop. I'm going to pass this over now to Mr. Scott Fields, who's one of our school council chairs, for some closing remarks from the school council.
I'm so sorry, Mr. Veals, if I could just interject for 1 minute. It's Ms. Johnson, the vice principal. I know the students have used the chat and continuing to use the chat. Students, please stop. It's very distracting. The chat is not for personal conversations. So if you could stop and listen, or else I'm going to disable the chat. Thank you, Mr. Veal. The floor is yours.
Great. Okay. Good evening. I'm so glad that you are considering Northview Heights Secondary School as your high school option. My name is Scott. I've been the school council chair into my ninth year at Northview as a co-chair, sharing the responsibility. All three of my sons have attended Northview and completed the HMST program. And it has been amazing over all of these years. Our family has found Northview to be an exceptional school, actually. From the admin leadership team, of which you're interacting with some of them tonight, from the teachers who put in this extra effort to be on a call like this, to all the specialized programs, to the stadium and the pool, to the extracurricular activities and the intramural sports, Northview has it all and even more. They can offer so much because we are the third largest school in the TDSB population-wise, and have the facilities to go with it and the staff that are heavily involved. I also am a community youth worker as my full-time job. So through that role over the years, I've probably had some interaction with almost every public high school in the northwest quadrant of the city. And personal opinion is Northview is the best school west of Yonge Street, north of Eglinton Avenue, in that whole quadrant. So I highly recommend that you seriously consider applying to some of the programs to have your child attend Northview. That's pretty much the only route. I don't know if this has been said clearly tonight, but optional attendance is not a very reliable route to get into Northview. So you really do need to apply to specialized programs if you're out of area, and that was my situation with my family. We do live out of area, but we're able to attend Northview through HMST program. Another great thing about Northview is you can be involved as a parent, obviously through school council, school parent council, as I am, but I've also had the privilege to be able to coach some teams at Northview. Mostly badminton over the years, but also soccer and basketball a bit. And that Northview senior basketball championship team from this past February as actually the assistant coach on that team, with my son being one of the players on it. So just overall, Northview's been an amazing school to be at for us as a family. And I'd highly recommend you make Northview your choice for next year. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Veals. It's Ms. Johnson again. So we're almost at the end, but I mentioned earlier that last week we had our specialty night, our information night for our specialty program. If you would like to apply for our APCA program, two things must occur. You must first fill out for all of our specialty programs, our APCA, our Cyber Arts, our Honors Math Science program. You must complete the optional attendance form. The optional attendance form can be found on our website. It has to be signed by your homeschool principal or a designate. Once the form is completed and signed, you can scan it, take a photo of it, and email it to our school's website, northview@tdsb.on.ca. Or you can physically drop it by. We wanted to give you the option of doing this electronically because of the pandemic. For the other programs, like APCA, you also have to fill out a school application form. That form can be found, again, on our website. It, for APCA, this application must be completed by January 8th, 2021. In addition to the application, you must provide supporting materials like a letter of intent, evidence of training. By the way, APCA stands for, this is our elite, this is our program for gifted athletes. So it's called the Academic Program for Gifted Athletes. And to apply for this program, you must be performing at a high level, regional, provincial, or international level in your particular sports. It is not, our school is not a training site. The APCA program gives us the opportunity to allow you to study in a very flexible way because of your training schedule, but your training is done by your various teams. Once again, the application for APCA is due January 28th. Now, the optional attendance form, I'm just going to take a moment to talk about that. The optional attendance form is to be completed for all of our specialty programs. This one, the APCA, the Cyber Arts program, the HMSD program, regardless of whether Northview is your home school or not, right? This form must be completed in addition to the application form that has asked specific questions based on the program you're going in. Next slide, please. Next slide, Cyber Arts. Their application is due December 11th, 2020. Their application process involves not only the application form, but an art portfolio that is due on Friday, January 8th, 2021. For all of the applications, all the applicants for APCA, Cyber Arts, as well as HMST, we do invite you to share your grade 7 report card. In the case of Cyber Arts, it has to be emailed and to martinsimpson@tdsb.on.ca. All the information on these specialized programs can be found on their respective pages on our main page. If you go on to www.northviewheights.ca, there's a link for Cyber Arts, there's a link for APTA, there's a link for HMST, or Honors Math Science Program, where you'll find more information. Next slide, please. HMST, same thing, our Honors Math Science Program. Their application consists of the application form itself, as well as a portfolio submission. The portfolio can include anything, awards, certificates, completion, participation in various science fairs or science projects. And with HMST, they will have an entrance exam. The entrance exam will be written on December 5th from 9:15 to 10:30 virtually. So it's a small virtual exam. The application itself, the form that you will be filling out for HMST is due Friday, November 27th. If you are applying just to a regular program, and you're outside of the our catchment area, meaning that Northview is not your home school, you only have to complete our optional attendance form, right? The rest of you, if you're applying for a specialty programs, you have to do both the optional attendance form as well as the our Northview application form. Mr. Villas mentioned if you want to get into our school and you're not in the area, the best way is through our specialty programs. We do have a limited number of students we can take from outside of district each year. And so if you want to I guess, increase your chances of getting in, then yes, best to go through our specialty programs. We are now going to open the night up for, if you have specific questions, to put them in the Q&A section on the chat, or here tonight we have the leaders of our specialty programs, Ms. Chin, Mr. Simpson is also here, plus our, the people you've seen before. So if you have some questions, the next 15 minutes, we'll try to do our best to answer as many of the questions that you have. Please post them in the Q&A section. Thank you very much.
Ms. Johnson, I was hoping to add two more points if possible.
Sorry Absolutely. About that.
Mm-hmm. The career pathways coming out of Northview are extreme. Like the options are incredible. And even in my own family, my eldest son did the Steps to Construction program and is already well along into his electrical apprenticeship and just being wildly successful financially and otherwise. My second son is in civil engineering at University of Waterloo. And it's very interesting when we applied to that university, we did some research and we found out that at least the others actually, gives certain high schools a certain amount of extra points depending what high school you come from. And again, Northview received the most points of any school in the Northwest quadrant of the city. So just another solid fact why this school is amazing. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Veals. So I am seeing a number of questions in the chat. My colleagues will try to get to as many of them as possible. I will, if we could maybe call out a few questions that may be mentioned multiple times, then we can address them. So for example, I see grade 7 report card, something about, the grade 7 report card has to be front page or back page. Scan the entire report card, that would be great. Do you guys have a dance club, dance competitions and apps? Well, we definitely have, I remember last year there was a hip hop group for sure. Can we sign up for regular program and special program if we get into the special program? If you are outside of our catchment area, meaning Northview is not your home school, and you're applying for a specialty program, we recommend you may want to consider applying as well for a regular program. So on the optional attendance form, you would put in both our HMST as well as regular program if you want to be considered for both. Miss Chin, if you're on, and Mr. Simpson, if you want to pop in and address any burning questions you may see that's coming up about your particular program.
I can mention, because I think I've answered the question 3 or 4 times about the application, the portfolio.
Absolutely.
There's information on the website and on the application form online. You were basically looking for anywhere from 8 to 12 pieces of artwork. It doesn't have to be polished or fully finished. Just looking for enthusiasm and your skills as they are right now. That can be emailed to me and martin.simpson@tdsb.on.ca. And I suggest you do it as a zip file or individual, or even if you wanted to attach it to something as simple as a Google website. If you have any questions, any concerns, just email me and I will answer you directly.
Ms. Chin, I see a question about how long is the HMST exam?
And how much did you study or prepare for it? Okay, so questions about the HMSD exam can be found, again, when you go on our website, www.northviewheights.ca. If you click on the HMSD link, it will give you all the information about the HMSD exam, including a link for practice questions for you to prepare for the exam on December 5th. I see questions about sibling. Historically, we give priority to students who have siblings in the school for regular program. Obviously, if your brother got into HMSD in grade 9, that means he met the requirements and won a spot. It doesn't mean that you get into HMSD the next year. But for a regular program, if you're outside of the area and you do have a sibling, that definitely is considered when we're making our considerations. Question about where is the link for the practice questions? Again, go on the school's website and click on the HMST. I see a lot of questions about grades and what mark would be best. When you access our application form, you will see that it's not only marks, it's just one component that we look at. So that's why we're always hesitant to say you have to have 90%, 70%, 60%, because we're looking at you as a whole child. So I know with HMST, there's a portfolio as well as interview, I'm sorry, with cyber arts rather, portfolio, interviews. It's not just your marks. So we're looking for well-rounded students, not just those who are focused only on the marks. Okay. All right. My grade 7, I'm trying to read as quickly. What credit is earned in the Jumpstart program? Ms. Jurek, are you still on? I know you've often participated in our Jumpstart program. Can you speak to that one?
I need to look up what credit that is.
Yeah, it's a well-rounded kind of, I'm not sure if it's a GLE one, but or leadership, but we'll look it up and get back to you.
It's an elective credit, and it's basically focused on learning skills is what the credit is. But in the program, they look at a variety of things. So they do some academic skill work. So they brush up on their math and some writing skills, but they also get to do phys ed. They get to try some of the different tech areas. They do a lot of team building and leadership games. Okay. So the credit, if I'm correct, falls under the learning skills categories.
So if I may interject here, the specific credit is HIF 101. And this particular, it's a family studies grade 9 open credit. And this particular credit lends itself to all of the different kinds of learning that take place during the Jumpstart summer course.
Okay. Thank you. All right, any more questions, burning questions? Okay, I know a couple of people are asking where can they find the application form, including the optional attendance. Please visit our school's website, www.northviewheights.ca. If one of my colleagues could paste it in the chat, we're starting to remove some students from the chat. As you've been warned. Where can I find this number, as we have only a student number? Ms. Tanrikulu, do you know where students, grade 7, 8 students, can see their OEN number?
You should be able to see their OEN number on a report card. So the report card would indicate this to the student's Ontario education number. So this number would follow the student irrespective of what board they're going to school in. So there is two numbers that the students have. They have for example, students attending school in Toronto District School Board, they will have a TDSB student number, and they will have a separate OEN number, which is their Ontario education number. So these two numbers are separate, but you should be able to find the OEN number on the report card.
Thank you. Thank you. All right. Let's see if there's any, somebody asked how many HMST or sub students actually get in. Again, it depends on the number of students who applied. Last year, for example, we accepted 120. Most years it's 90 students, three classes. Do I have to provide grade 7 report card if finished grade 7 in another country? Yes, we do need to get some report card. That'd be great. Somebody said they can't find their report card. Then you can contact your school and they should be able to send you a copy.
Ms. Johnson, this is Ms. Tanrikulu. May I also just mention about the applications for the Summer Jumpstart Program and when they will be available?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Okay, so a lot of parents are interested in having their child participate in our Summer Jumpstart Program, which is a fantastic opportunity. We've been running this program since 2014 and with great success. So applications registration will be available in April. It will be found on it will be through a Google form, and it will be available on our Northview Heights main site on our webpage, and there will be a clear indicator specifying that it is a Google form, a registration for the Jumpstart program. And the Jumpstart will start in July, beginning of July, and will end at the end of July, but more information will be available, like I said, along with the registration in April on our website.
Thank you. Right, so we just a couple more. It's a few minutes before 8 and we're slotted to end at 8. A couple of students have asked about how do they submit their report card for regular program or specialized program if it's not in an electronic format. Your children are quite tech savvy. They can scan, take a picture or download a scanning app, scan to get an electronic version, and that they either upload while filling out the application for HMST or for CyberEyes, for example. I know they're instructed to email it. Once you access the online application form, all the instructions are there to guide you as to how you submit, how you need to send the information. For example, for the optional attendance form, we tell you where to send it. There's an email address to send it, and we also give you the option of dropping it off like a physical hard copy. Let's see what else is there. So let me just scroll down. How do we get the signature on the form if it's online? Again, a couple of things. You can send the form to your principal or your principal designate. They can actually sign it electronically and return it to you, or the old fashioned way, they print it out, copy it, scan it and return it back to you. With the pandemic, we're trying to limit movements. That's why the option of signing them electronically or having them sent through email is available this year. Again, I'm seeing questions about where do you submit the portfolio? Great questions, but all the answers to these questions will be entered if you log on to our website, and there'll be information. I'm applying for a regular program, our specialty program. You click on the link, it will give you the information that you need as to how to apply.
if Northview isn't your home school and we apply to attend regular program, is it picked randomly or by grades? Depending on the number of students or number of spaces we're given by the board each year, it will most, if we have more applicants than spaces, then yes, we will get into a lottery where you're picked randomly, not by your marks, it would be random. Of course, we mentioned before, priority will be given to students who already have a sibling or who has a sibling in the school. It is 8:01. Thank you so much for coming. Ms. Karuna, if you want to, if you're still there, we can wrap up and end the night.
Thank you, Ms. Johnson. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank all the parents, guardians, and students to participate in Northview's Grade 8 Program Information Night. I hope you found it useful and productive. And as it was reiterated numerous times, Northview is one of the amazing places to be in. This year, I'm new here, and I already feel that it's such a special place where everyone's welcome and included. I'd like to also take this opportunity to thank School Council, Scott Wheels, and the other co-chairs, and also our brilliant team of teachers and department heads who are here today and who took their time to make this presentation successful and answer questions from the chat. So thank you to the entire Northview team that was behind tonight. And thank you to you all. We're going to be posting the recording from our presentation tonight on our website. Have a great night, everyone. Hope to see you and welcome you at Northview soon. Bye-bye.
Bye, everyone.